We now begin our look at the interior of the Earth. At some point, you undoubtedly learned that the Earth has three basic parts to it: the core, the mantle, and the crust. In some ways, our planet is analogous to an egg, where an egg also has three components: the yolk, the white, and the shell. Also, in some ways, the percentages of each of these things line up, so that about 1% of the total mass of an egg is the shell. About 1% of the total mass of our planet is the crust. Likewise, the mantle composes a similar percentage to our planet as the white does to an egg. And the core composes a similar percentage to our planet as the yolk does to an egg. We're going to begin our look at the Earth's interior, however, by starting with earthquakes, because without the study of earthquakes, we would not know what is inside the planet. After all, in reality, human beings have only been in direct contact with the crust. Let's start by doing this. Earthquakes are the result of movement along a fault line or because of volcanic activity. We're going to focus on the fault line part. A fault or a fault line is a crack, fracture, or breakage zone in the Earth's crust where slippage has occurred. If you take a look at this diagram, I just highlighted the fault line in black. The arrow is pointing at the fault line. What you should also be able to see is this. To the left of that black fault line, there's half of a red arrow that indicates the block to the left is being lifted, whereas to the right of the fault line, you can see that there's half of a red arrow that indicates the block to the right of the fault line is dropping down. That area between those two blocks of land, the one on the left that's rising, the one on the right that's subsiding, is the fault line, or as the diagram indicates, the fault plane, which is probably a better description. When an earthquake happens, there's going to be a place along the fault line where the initial movement occurs. We call that place the focus. This is the place within the Earth where the first movement happens. In other words, this is where the earthquake is generated from. That doesn't mean that along the fault plane there aren't other places that break and fracture. It's just that the focus is the initial movement site. Whenever an earthquake happens and you turn on the news, they never speak about the focus, though, do they? What they tell you about is the epicenter. The epicenter is the place on the surface directly above the focus. So, for example, the 1994 earthquake in Southern California is referred to as the Northridge earthquake. In reality, Northridge was the epicenter, but the earthquake happened miles below Northridge. But how do you discuss the focus with average human beings? That's right, you don't. So what do? You give them something to relate to. Anybody can look at a map and see where Northridge is. That's the point of the epicenter, to give us as surface dwellers something to relate to. So the focus is actually where the earthquake starts. However, the place on the surface that we relate to is called the epicenter, but the epicenter is directly above the focus.